days, there have been a massive surge in coronavirus cases across the country. In fact, in Mumbai, since January 1, the number of cases have gone up by nearly 1,000% and the positivity has hovered around 20%. But this time around, it is not just common Mumbaikars who are getting infected, but also the doctor faculty as well as the healthcare workers. So how is it working for doctors in such stressful conditions? We'll try and find out by speaking to many doctors across the city in various hospitals.
This is BMC-run Lokmanya Tilak General Hospital, also known as Sion Hospital. This is a COVID hospital too and witnessed many patients in the first and second wave, especially those from lower economic strata, but now it is facing a resource crunch.
I'll give you an example. I have 23 doctors, resident doctors working with me, and I have 3 other faculty. At present, of the 23, only 9 are working. So it is more than half the faculty is, resident doctors are not working. And at present, one of my faculty is also down with the COVID. So the faculty is also getting infected. Now what this has meant is that we run our OPD and OT services every day. OT is operation theatre and OPD is the outpatient. We run it every day. But because there's less than half the doctors, we have had to postpone elective surgery. By elective surgery, we mean something like a tonsil or, correction of the nasal septum, which is crooked. So these kind of cases, which whether you operate now or you operate 3 months later, it doesn't matter. Those kind of cases we've had to postpone. One of our things is also to train surgeons. So we have to train our resident doctors to become surgeons. But because of this, so many falling ill, and because of doctors' services are stressed, we're not able to do the training as we would like to. So definitely the doctors are suffering, not only because they are giving duties in COVID, not only because they are less in number, but also what training needs to be given to them is not being possible because of so many of them being ill.
According to the data provided by the Maharashtra Residents Doctors Association and the government sources, nearly 500 resident doctors have tested positive for coronavirus since January 1 in Mumbai alone. In fact, we are right outside KAM Hospital, and even here, nearly 105 resident doctors have tested positive, and because of which, some of its services are also getting affected.
Dr. Sanchari Pal, a resident doctor in her second year of medical school, has been working overtime, filling in for sick colleagues. At times, she is clocking in 36 to 40 hours at a stretch post-emergency operations.
In my department, there are 21 residents posted in KAM, and 15 of them are positive. So they're not working. So it's a huge, huge resource crunch that we're working with. And though, however hard we might try to do our best, but patient care somewhere down the line is getting affected. Yeah. So elective procedures are on hold throughout KAM. Only emergency surgical interventions or emergency procedures are being carried out. In my department, elective OTs are completely short. So it's the same thing in other departments as well, in order to reduce a little bit of the workload, because we don't have any workforce at this point. Though, however hard we might try to do our best, but patient care somewhere down the line is getting affected, because at the end of the day, an exhausted human being, an exhausted doctor is more prone to make mistakes than a well-rested one.
The private sector has also started getting affected, and not just doctors, but even other medical staff are impacted.
We have been strained for the resources of healthcare workers, and many of our workers had to do overtime also to meet up the demand and the necessity of the patient's requirement. Now in this type of situation, when the people were sick and the entire duty, no one is there available, then at times we have had to have our staff working overtime. And this definitely has affected them also. And whenever it takes at least 5 days for recovery of the previous employees, for nearly 5 days then people have to overtime, they have to do overtime, make up for the loss of the staff which has been there, so that patient care does not suffer.
What the doctors told us is that there is extreme fatigue and tiredness amongst the faculty. In fact, for the past 2 years, they have been relentlessly working on coronavirus cases, and that has affected their mental as well as physical well-being.
major issues that these people are facing is that they are feeling very burnt out. So many doctors are there that they come and they say, doctor, we are not finding any joy in the work that we are doing. We feel constantly exhausted. Even in the morning when we are getting up, there is no energy from within. Our body is aching. So all of these are signs of burnt out, and this is becoming very, very common. Secondly, there is also a background fear that although we are frontline workers, although we are doing whatever we can for the patients, we have a chance, despite taking the vaccine, we have a chance of getting corona, COVID, and there is a certain background anxiety because of that, and that is making, unfortunately, matters worse for certain people. Apart from that, this is again something which is persistent and pervasive, and that is the lack of sleep because of overworked hours, because of too much of a working stress. They are not getting good sleep. That is resulting into they having higher chances of getting clinically depressed or having anxiety problems. That is one thing. Secondly, because of decreased sleep, they are not having a good immunity. Their immunity is going for a toss. And when the corona is, unfortunately, if at all, hitting them, then they might not have very mild symptoms despite taking the vaccine. So that is also something that is a big botheration for the healthcare workers, for the doctors per se. Apart from that, to make matters worse, again, majority of the public and the mentality that is prevailing right now is that of pre-COVID, wherein even though now the government is saying and healthcare officials are saying that the COVID cases are increasing, over the past 2-3 months, because of festive season and other things, many people have been unfortunately behaving in a way that COVID has gone and gone forever. And that is why we are seeing this sudden spike.
Now, whether this wave has already peaked in Mumbai or not, and whether these number of cases in the next few days will plateau or not, only time will tell. But the doctors would surely hope that they get the booster precautionary dose as quickly as they can, so that not many doctors fall ill to coronavirus, and also they can work without any anxiety. In Mumbai, this is Surva Chitra for The Print.